ഇന്ന് ഓൺലൈൻ സയൻസ് സ്കൂൾ നിങ്ങൾക്കായി എടുക്കാൻ പോകുന്നത് സി ബി എസ് ഇ ടെൻത്ത് ക്ലാസ്സിലെ സെക്കൻഡ് ചാപ്റ്റർ ദ ആസിഡ് ബേസസ് ആൻഡ് സോൾട്ട് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ചാപ്റ്ററിലെ കെമിക്കൽസ് ഫ്രം കോമൺ സോൾട്ട് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന പോർഷനാണ്. ഈ വീഡിയോ ഇഷ്ടമായെങ്കിൽ ചാനൽ സബ്സ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്യാൻ മറക്കരുത്.
ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ് സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്. വി ഹാവ് ലേൺഡ് ദാറ്റ് ദ സോൾട്ട് ഫോംഡ് ബൈ ദ കോമ്പിനേഷൻ ഓഫ് ഹൈഡ്രോക്ലോറിക് ആസിഡ് ആൻഡ് സോഡിയം ഹൈഡ്രോക്സൈഡ് സൊല്യൂഷൻ ഈസ് നോൺ ആസ് sodium chloride. It is also known as common salt. This is a salt that we used in food and it is a neutral salt. So today we are going to discuss about the common salt, that is NaCl, sodium chloride. The common salt thus obtained is an important raw material for synthesizing various materials of daily use. So today we are going to discuss about the role of sodium chloride for synthesizing so many chemicals that we use in our daily life. First point, common salt is also known as table salt. Then it has a chemical formula, that is NaCl, sodium chloride. And let's have a look on the uses of common salt. It acts as a raw material for various materials of daily use, such as first one, NaOH, sodium hydroxide, that is also commonly known as caustic soda, and the second one, NaHCO3, that is sodium bicarbonate, commonly known as baking soda, and the next one, Na2CO3, sodium carbonate, which is also known as washing soda. And the last, CaOCl2, that is calcium oxychloride. This is commonly known as bleaching powder. First, we are going to learn how sodium hydroxide or caustic soda is formed from sodium chloride or common salt. This sodium hydroxide can be synthesized from sodium chloride by a process known as chlor-alkali process. The chlor-alkali process is an industrial process for the electrolysis of sodium chloride solution. It is the technology used to produce chlorine gas and sodium hydroxide, which are commodity chemicals that are required by industry. Now we are going to discuss about the chlor-alkali process. We have seen that chlor-alkali process is used to synthesize the aqueous sodium hydroxide from sodium chloride. When electricity is passed through an aqueous solution of sodium chloride, it will decompose to form sodium aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide, chlorine gas and hydrogen gas. This whole process is known as the chlor-alkali process. The process is called the chlor-alkali process because the products formed, chlor is for chlorine, alkali for sodium hydroxide. This is the chemical equation for the chlor-alkali process, that is 2NaCl plus 2H2O gives 2NaOH plus Cl2 plus H2. This is the balanced chemical equation for the chlor-alkali process. Then some important points you have to notice about the chlor-alkali process are, we have said that the reactant was an aqueous sodium chloride. The aqueous sodium chloride is generally known as brine. The solution is known as brine. And then the chlorine gas is given off at the anode and the hydrogen gas is evolved at the cathode during electrolysis. And finally, the sodium hydroxide solution is formed near the cathode during the electrolysis process. So it's all about the chlor-alkali process. The chemical equation is very important. You have to know the reactant and product of chlor-alkali process, and notice what is brine. It is an aqueous sodium chloride. Then in anode, chlorine gases are evolved, and at cathode, hydrogen gas is given off, and NaOH is formed near cathode. It's all about the process, chlor-alkali process. Moving on to the next topic, we have to discuss about the important products that are formed from chlor-alkali process. We have seen that during this chlor-alkali process, the electrolysis of sodium hydroxide will produce hydrogen gas at cathode, chlorine gas at anode, and sodium hydroxide solution nearby cathode. These three products produced in this process are all very useful. Let us have a look. First one, hydrogen. Hydrogen is used in as fuels, margarine, and used for the synthesis of ammonia for fertilizers. Second one, chlorine. Chlorine is used for water purification, that is water treatment, used in swimming pools for water purification, then used for the synthesis of PVC, used in disinfectants, chlorofluorocarbons, pesticides, etc. And the last, sodium hydroxide. It is used in degreasing of metals, used in soaps and detergents, also used in paper making, and used for the synthesis of artificial fibers. Further, if we combine these chemicals together by chemical reactions, we will get another chemical compounds. That is, combining hydrogen and chlorine through chemical reaction, we will get hydrochloric acid, that is HCl. It is used in cleaning steel, production of ammonium chloride, used in medicines, cosmetics, etc. And next, a combination of sodium hydroxide and chlorine together by chemical reaction will produce bleach. Bleach is used for used as household bleaches, and also used for bleaching fabrics. So today's all these portions we were discussing about the common salt and its role in used as a raw material for the synthesis of so many chemicals. First, we have seen that the chlor-alkali process, that is the process of producing sodium hydroxide by the electrolysis of aqueous sodium chloride, that is called brine. We have seen that during this process, NaOH, hydrogen, chlorine, all these products are formed, and further all these products are used for various purposes also. So it's all about this class. Thank you.